And so motherfucking fly. Young Sam, you know where to find me, nigga. Yeah. I roll solo in the club like a mob figure. And you can tell by my appearance about my figures. A born hustler, a loyalist to my niggas. Taking straight shots at the ball and I'm high, nigga. The club owners know me, bumps love to see me coming. In a 300M, the color of onions. We never with the frontin', these cats know the time. So when I glow and shine, these chicken heads know it's mine. This how you supposed to grind, I'll show you how to do this.
What's up, y'all? I'm Mike Mosey, super producer, you know what I'm saying, about the Yay. On this independent rap documentary, you know, we're going to show you how to do it from the independent way, the major way in this game. You know, a lot of behind-the-scenes footage of me and some of my homeboys, you know what I'm saying, throughout the industry. You know, I interviewed a few people, and we're going to let y'all know what's really cracking in this game. So, I got, you know, some behind-the-scenes footage of Tupac, Sebo, TQ, Big John from EMI, my homeboy Coognut, E40, Franzen, you know what I'm saying, K-Lou from No Limit, A1, my rappers out there in Pontiac, Michigan, you know what I'm saying, MGB from my homies out there in Pontiac, you know, we got Big Hollis, we got Rap Rock, we got, you know, just all type of people in this industry, you know what I'm saying, that I just reached out and touched, and we put it all together, you know what I'm saying, just for your viewing pleasure. So check this out.
All right. Name is Big John Platt, Senior Vice President at EMI Music Publishing in Los Angeles. How I got into the business was I used to DJ in Denver, Colorado. DJ for like from about starting in like 1985 to like the early 90s. People of that nature. And you know, it just kept on rolling to the point now where we got like a real strong squad that I work with, you know, like I say, from Mike Mosley to AZ to Jay-Z, Crazy Bone, Usher, Warren Campbell, Tamar Savage, Cannabis, just Crazy Bone. I think I said him already, but it goes
on. What's up, y'all? Okay, my name is Lisa Left Eye Lopez. I'm chilling with my man, Mike Mosley. And
my man is right here, you know.
Mike Mosley.
Stay the sucker free.
Yeah.
My nigga Mike Mosley,
E40. Let him know. Get fingerprints.
No fingerprints.
You know. That's originated. That's originated from out the wire, too, guy. You know.
Let me update y'all, though, on this Sick with It Foundation. We got Mr. Capone coming out, you know what I'm saying, from the Memphis area. You know what I'm saying? Then we got the MOSSIE. You know what I'm saying? We got Rhythm X, the Reservoir Hogs, and whatnot. We got Lavitty busting it down real quick, like there. You know what I'm saying? Then we got Shit TD shot. We got movies in the whole show. Oh boy, we
the movie
so
came out
big.
Tonight, though.
Oh boy, I'm so handsome.
We are so big.
You know?
Oh boy.
Yeah, that's a big spit, you
so
know.
Big.
Yeah, ain't nothing camouflage about this, nigga, you know. Yeah, we does this, you know. Yeah, yeah. Ordinary motherfuckers, man, you know. You know, screwionaires, man, you know. In this motherfucker, real tough, like, you know. Yeah, believe that, nigga. Yeah.
So I know E40 is. I know E40 from just like being in the traffic, being in the streets, you know, on the other side of the fence, just gritting and grinding. I know him through there, and then he didn't know that I was making. He just happened to come by my house one day. He's like, "Man, you make beats?" He's like, "Man, I'm rapping. Man, I did this album, All the Kings Men." He showed me the album cover, so you know, we just end up clicking ever since from there, you know.
Basically, me and Mike went to Vegas. We just kind of locked ourselves in the studio. We went up there. We didn't have no kind of concept. We didn't have no nothing. All I had was the things that I remembered, stuff I wanted to write about. And all he had was basically his beats in his head. We took equipment up there, just locked ourselves away. We'd go for like 2 weeks out of every month and just bang songs out the clear blue, just from scratch. We had two rooms going. He'd be in one room making the track. I'd be in the other room writing the song and laying the vocals down. And we just put it together like that, and it's a formula that works.
Well, I got started in this business as a DJ. That's how I came into the business first. Started doing a lot of little house parties and, you know, selling mixtapes. And, you know, then as a result, as time came along, NWA and everybody started coming out. You know, I started making little beats and whatnot. Bought a couple of little pieces of equipment. I started making drum beats and just started playing around ever since then, you know. Then I figured out that you can make money doing it, but I just didn't know how.
Like Hiroshima.
Like napalm.
I don't think they really want to see us.
Motherfucker.
Multi-platinum plaques.
Mike got them already. I got to get some of my damn self, though. It's on. We're going to put it together. Believe that. Believe that. Yeah. It's cracking, baby. It's cracking. Believe that. Y'all about to see these coming. They going to be coming for years on your ass. Trust me. Y'all going to be watching this tape years down the road. Y'all going to be like, damn. Them niggas said.
What's your relationship with Mike Mosley?
Me and Mike Mosley go back since my first album, Gas Chamber. I met Mike Mosley through Lil Bruce. Lil Bruce hooked me up with him, you know. So you don't have to go pick him up and bring him out the closet, you know what I'm saying? You know, get his first recognitions.
So do you anticipate any future work with Mike Mosley?
Mike did a lot of work for me. Did my first album, Gas Chamber. There's several songs on all my albums for me.
15 to 20 albums I produced.
How many units have they sold?
Probably about, count of Tupac's off, it's probably about 30 million pieces of product that I done moved, at least with my production skills on it, you know. Just from networking, you know.
Like I was saying, you know, it really takes persistence, and if you want to blow up, concentrate on the streets first. Concentrate on the streets and selling your shit out the trunk like 40 and Short did, you know what I mean? So, I mean, that's really all I can say. You know, I wish I could, there's a lot of talented artists in the Bay Area that don't get recognized, and you know what, I kind of get pissed at it, because sometimes I can't really, you know, play the records or whatnot, but, you know, you guys got to understand out there that the decision's not on me.
I'm coming out with this cat named Savior. Got this dude named, little cat named Savior from Michigan. Got Cognito. Got this cat named D-Buck. Got this R&B dude named Aaron Mason. I got my album. Then I got some compilations. I got some DVDs, some CDs, some mixtapes, all kind of crazy stuff. Try my lips across the line with my